Parliament held a special session yesterday afternoon to pay their last respect to the late Simon Peter Alipe, the National Resistance Movement vice chairperson for the Karamoja sub-region. The casket containing his remains was received by the Speaker of Parliament Anita Mong and her deputy Thomas Tayewa, among other officials. Preceding the laying of wreaths, Tayewa was the first to eulogize Alipe, highlighting his outstanding performance.
He also worked hard to ensure that children from Karamoja were off the streets of Kampala.
Vice President Jessica Lupo expressed her condolence to the nation and specifically to NRM for the loss. Lupo eulogized Alipe as a leader who was dedicated to serving his people diligently and stood for what he believed in.
And would always stand and speak about what he stood for very loudly and clearly here in the house and also outside.
The late Honorable Alipe Simon Peter was a hard-working member of the NRM who rose through the ranks.
Alipe 50 died on Tuesday in a car crash on the Iganga-Tirini Highway. He survived by 7 children.
We are gathered here today in profound sorrow and deep respect to pay tribute to a colleague who has served in this parliament and in other capacities.
A team of Green Schools Initiative evaluators from Team A have been traversing Uganda, starting with West Nile to the north, and now they are in the Middle West. They are assessing how schools in these regions are addressing climate change.
So, and this is Mother Nature. She has flowers on her head, she has a burst of colors, but then her smile has gone worn.
The schools that will demonstrate the most effective measures will be awarded prizes.
Environment! Environment!
Located in Uganda's Midwest, in Bundibugyo District, on the Uganda Democratic Republic of Congo border, is Semuliki High School. It is one of the 5 schools that was visited by the evaluators. Other schools assessed include Kabalega Secondary School, Chebambe Girls Secondary School, St. Leo's Chegobe, and Nyakasura Primary School. Among the 5 schools visited, the first thing that stood out was their lushy green compounds. As you entered the gates, you could see the well-maintained green spaces, a testament to the school's efforts to protect the environment.
Like you can see, Bundibugyo, this month, it was known as a sunny month, but we are expressing rain for the almost the last week. We have expressed rain daily, and this is climate change. So as a patriotic Ugandan, I cannot sit and see this. I have to come on and solve the things. We have still planted trees.
Everything that takes place in our environment begins with you, because it is you first who starts to dump waste around, to not manage the waste very properly. It is you first who chooses to cut down trees. It is at the same hand, it is you first.
As a media house, Vision Group as a media house, together with the partners, we are taking out the message, providing platforms where the correct information can be given.
The schools have implemented various innovations aimed at mitigating climate change, a significant threat to human life and the environment. This initiative is organized by Vision Group and the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations, and it is funded by the Embassy of Sweden. A new electrified commuter railway in Tanzania, meant to modernize travel in the traffic-plagued country, made its inaugural journey between the commercial hub Dar es Salaam and the capital Dodoma yesterday. Built by a Turkish company, the 440-kilometer, 273-mile line is part of a 2,561-kilometer standard-gauge railway network expected to connect the north and west of the country to Dar es Salaam and Indian Ocean Port City. The air-conditioned carriages from South Korea with built-in Wi-Fi have already developed a fan club among travelers wary of the ramshackle, diesel-spewing buses that dominate public transport in the nation of nearly 62 million people. a fast line connecting the eastern Morogoro region to Dar es Salaam, some 200 kilometers apart, was launched last month, also built by Turkey's Yapi Makezi. Tanzania Railway Corporation said it will operate daily trips between Dodoma and Dar es Salaam, cutting the usual lengthy bus trip by more than half to around 3.5 hours. The project, in one of Africa's fastest-growing economies, is the cornerstone of a transformation plan by President Samia Suluhu Hassan ahead of national elections next year.